Robomate Plus, India's largest curriculum-based study app. Download the app now.
In this video, we shall have an understanding of Social Studies CBSE board paper pattern for the year 1819. Now, when it comes to social studies, you have history, geography, political science, as well as economics. Talking about history, history is in three sections. Section one has events and processes. Now, in this, you will have three chapters: the rise of nationalism in Europe, the nationalist movement in Indochina, and nationalism in India. Now, the third one is compulsory, whereas the other two are optional. You have to choose any one out of that. Talking about section two, you have livelihoods, economies, and societies. In this, you have three chapters: the making of a global world, the age of industrialization, work, life, and leisure. Out of this, you need to select one. Talking about section three, we have everyday life, culture, and politics. Now, in this again, you have two chapters: print culture and a modern world, and novels, society, and history. Now, out of this, you need to select one. Talking about political science, altogether in the textbook, you have eight chapters. Now, the good thing is, out of these eight chapters, fifth one, that is popular struggles and movements, is deleted, or I will say omitted, for the exams. So, you need to prepare for only seven chapters. Coming to geography. In geography, in the textbook, again, you have seven chapters. And out of that, the second chapter is omitted. Name of the chapter is Forest and Wildlife Resources. Talking about the fourth chapter, that is agriculture. In agriculture, the content on the page number 44 to 47 is again deleted. And the topics are contribution of agriculture to national economy, employment, and output and food security. Now, all these are deleted. In chapter number 6, the content, that is from page number 74 up to just 75, the topics are only for project work. That means there will be no questions coming in the exam. The topics are aluminium smelting, chemical industry, fertilizer industry, cement industry. So all these topics are not there. When it comes to economics, you have altogether five chapters, and you need to study all the five chapters. Talking about some general instructions. Now, if you take up the question paper, you have four sections, that is A, B, C, and D. And all together, you have 26 questions. And all 26 questions are compulsory. If I take section A, now section A has seven questions, that is starting from 1 to 7. And these are short answers. That is, you need to answer in one sentence because each one carries one mark. Then again, if I take section B, you have questions from 8 up to 18. Now, these questions carry 3 marks. So, you have to answer in 3 sentences, and your answer should be to the point, and your answer should not exceed more than 80 words. One more thing that you need to remember is from the first section and the second section, the questions, that is for 1 mark and 3 mark, you will also have choices. That is, some questions will also have an optional one with the word or. Then, if I take up 3 mark questions, sometimes the question can be application based. When I say application based, they will not just ask you geography. They will tell you, say, I'm giving an example, say, Kulwant Singh owns a farm in Uttar Pradesh. He wishes to cultivate either jute or sugarcane. Now, which crop out of these two should he cultivate, keeping in mind the conditions required for their growth? Explain. Now, when you are asked such a question, first thing is you should have an understanding of the climatic conditions of Uttar Pradesh. Second one, you must know when it comes to jute and sugarcane, what are the requirements? Based on that understanding, you have to develop an answer and write. So, you will also have questions that would be application based. Then, going to the next section, that is section C, the questions will be from 19 to 25. Now, in this, you will have all the questions carrying 5 marks each. So, your answer must be in 5 sentences and your answer should not exceed more than 100 words. Coming to the final section, that is section D. Here you have questions based on map, and the question based on map will be from geography as well as from history. When it comes to geography, it will be 3 marks, and when it comes to history, it will be 2 marks. If I take up geography questions, you will be given 5 questions, and out of that, you need to answer 3. So you have to mark everything with pencil on the map that is provided to you. You should show an index. And supposing you have attempted 3 questions, 1, 2, and 3, labeling should be done. The labeling should be done in capital letters. And then appropriately, the same thing should be shown in the index. Similarly, you will be getting 2 questions from history, and you have to mark the appropriate places and show the same in the index. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video lecture. To watch more such interesting videos, attempt tests, and to get instant analysis, download the Robomate Plus app now.